Hi, it's me, Kim. I thought I would talk today for my In the Trenches video about a certain kind of loss, about the loss of a child. I have a lot of people that come to me with this kind of loss, and it's pretty profound. I can't say I've experienced it personally. It would be horrible. Anyone who's a parent knows that would be horrible. And so I felt like it was important today just to kind of share this video or talk to you about the loss of a child, not necessarily from the perspective of a parent, because from the perspective of the parent who's living, I don't know if you could ever like fully understand the grief and loss there if you haven't experienced it yourself. So it's always good to have people who support you, who understand that kind of loss. Today, I just want to talk about what it's like when a child comes to a reading to see their parents. And it's really awesome. Sometimes the love of that child, depending on their age and the situation and stuff that's gone on, might not necessarily always be felt. Just because we have all these things when we grieve, these woulda, coulda, shoulda kind of things. And so sometimes we don't necessarily always feel that child or expect that child to show up the way they do. But when they show up, I swear, I get this feeling of, oh, that's my mom, or oh, that's my dad, that's my sister, that's my whatever. Like, there's so much excitement there to get to talk to that parent because they really do recognize all the grief and pain and hardship that comes after that loss. It's a very exciting time for the soul to come and connect with their parent and be like, I'm okay. But because of all the different ways that people lose their children, there's a lot more questions for those who are left behind. Like, one, are they okay? Two, if they're okay, what are they doing? And then, why aren't they here? And how do they talk to me? And all of those things are very important questions that would come from a parent. From the perspective of the child who's very excited, they always want to give some kind of healing to their parents. Whether their parent was a jerk and they need to say, look, I know why you were like that and I love you anyway, or whether their parent was the closest person to them, or whether their mom only got to hold them once as a baby, whatever it is, they seem to kind of want to come through and bring some healing to the parent who's left behind. So I just want to tell you from the perspective of the child, it starts off as, oh, I'm so excited to see them. And then it moves on to, what can I give them? What do they need from me right now? And so they share that in a reading, but that's a reading. And so the thing is that's just a reading. What about the rest of the time? That's like a half hour, an hour of your life. What about the rest of the time when you're missing them? How are they around? How are they showing up in your life? I know that children communicate in things that remind you of them. So definitely look for those little signs and synchronicities that remind you of your child. And you might think to yourself, oh, well, it's just a coincidence. It was just a fluke of nature or something. But the reality is that the more connected you become to that child or any spirit in the spirit world, the more you will start experiencing those little signs and synchronicities and little events that make you think, well, maybe he's still with me. Maybe she didn't leave me forever. And so there's all these little synchronicities that start to happen more and more and more. And the more you move through your grief, and I'm not telling you to get over it. It's not like get over it. It's just like you move forward, you progress through your grief. There's a process of it. And as you progress through that grief, I find that one of the most healing, beautiful things that happens is when a parent has moved through their grief with their child still with them. Instead of that message that we seem to send, which is like, you got to move on, you got to get over it. It's different. It's different for people when they grieve and they bring their kid with them. It's like the feeling of moving on in life, but carrying them still close to you, whether it's the ashes that you carry, or whether it's every time you go in a job interview, you play their favorite song, or whether you see their favorite movie on TV. If someone was a skateboarder and you're constantly seeing skateboards or something, it's all those little synchronicities start to align to let you know that their spirit is still close and that they still love you and that they're not going anywhere. But as you move through your grief, like, it's so awesome to see people move through their grief and bring their kid with them and know that that's not the end. It's just the end of an experience of life, For that child, but it's not the end of the experience of love with that child. So that's what I wanted to share today. I just wanted to tell you, look for your kids. They're all around, and it is a very difficult loss. It's not something to be diminished. I remember once when my kid's dad had died, and I remember someone saying to me, well, the loss of a child is the hardest loss. And I remember that time, because I had just lost someone that I really loved, that the person that said that to me, I kind of wanted to slap him in the face. I was like, don't say that to me. In retrospect, here I am doing this 13 years later, and I understand that to be true. But at the time, it's not, maybe wasn't really the best thing to say. Well, you know, you lost this person, but at least it wasn't your kid. You know, like, that's not something to say to a grieving person. But please understand, for those of you parents out there who have a child who you've lost, just know that that child is close to you no matter how they passed, and that that love remains and doesn't end, that they're always with you. So hopefully this is helpful to someone, and I hope you guys have an awesome day. Thanks.